Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm talking about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series JavaScript Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about memoization. Memoization is a programming technique or optimization technique which attempts to increase a function's performance by caching its previously computed results. It is especially useful in recursive functions. Not only in JavaScript, memoization is followed in many other programming languages also. Let me explain how memoization works. Let us take this function which is created to calculate the factorial of a number. This is a recursive function. That means this function calls itself again and again. Assume we are calculating factorial of 4. In that case, this function will be called again for factorial of 3, factorial of 2, and factorial of 1. If there is no memoization, if you are calculating factorial of 5 next, then it will again call for factorial of 4, factorial of 3, factorial of 2, and factorial of 1. But if there is memoization, the previous results will be stored, and so next time we can skip calculating the factorial of 4, 3, 2, and 1. In simple programs, we cannot expect a lot of performance improvement when we use memoization. But in bigger programs, we can see significant improvements. Let me show you that using an example. I'm taking this function which returns the nth number in the Fibonacci series. And here we can see it is a recursive function. Let me execute this first and show you the performance problem. When I pass 2, it is giving me result immediately. We can see the code execution time here. When I pass 10, we are getting the result immediately, but we can see the execution time is slightly increased. Let me try 40. Now we can see a little delay of 1 to 2 seconds. Let me try 42. We can see it is further increased. Let me try 44. Now we can see that the code execution is in progress. And now the execution time is increased a lot. So if I give any more higher number, then we may have to wait a lot. Let me stop this manually. Now let us implement memoization and see the result. First, let me create a cache object which is going to be empty. And then inside this function, let me check whether this number is present in the keys of the cache object. If present, then I am assigning its value in the value variable. Otherwise, I am executing the logic. And here, let me add the key and value to the cache object, so that next time it will skip this calculation. So if I execute now, it is giving the result immediately. Even if I give any bigger number, it is going to give us the result immediately. Hope you understood the use of memoization. I believe you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.